Good morning, class 9. In our last class, I had finished the parallel ranges of Himalaya, namely Himadri, Himachal and Shivalik. Today, we'll see the other division of Himalaya, that is the regional division of Himalaya from west to east. And these divisions have been demarcated by the rivers, the river valleys rather. Okay, so these divisions are, as you can see, the Punjab Himalaya, the Kumaon Himalaya, the Nepal Himalaya and the Assam Himalaya from west to east. The part of Himalaya, the first one is Punjab Himalaya. The part of Himalaya which lies between Indus and Satluj river is known as Punjab Himalaya. But in Himachal Pradesh, this part of Himalaya is also known as Himachal Himalaya. And in Kashmir, it is known as Kashmir Himalaya. Okay. All the major rivers of Indus river system flow through Punjab Himalayas. Jhelum, Chenab, Satluj, okay, they all. A large portion of Punjab Himalaya is in Jammu and Kashmir and Himachal Pradesh, and therefore I told you they are also called as Kashmir and Himachal Himalaya. The Karakoram, Ladakh, Pir Panjal, Jaskar, Dharadhar, they all are the major ranges of Punjab Himalaya. And the general elevation, it is falls westward, towards west. Okay. So this was about Punjab Himalaya. Next is the Kumaon Himalaya. The part of Himalaya which lies between Satluj and Kali River is known as Kumaon Himalaya. The Kumaon Himalayas lie in Uttaranchal or Uttarakhand and extends from Satluj River to the Kali River. The lesser Himalayas in Kumaon Himalayas is represented by the Mussoorie Range. The Shivalik in this region runs south of Mussoorie Range between the Ganga and Yamuna rivers. The flat valley between the Lesser Himalaya and the Shivalik range are called dunes, which Dehradun is the most famous, which I taught you in the previous class. Okay. Now third is Nepal Himalayas. 800 km the part of Himalaya between Kali and Tista river is Nepal Himalaya. The Great Himalaya range attains maximum height in this portion. Some of the world's famous peak like Mount Everest, Kanchenjunga, Makalu, Annapurna, Dhaulagiri, they all are located in this part of Himalaya, that is Nepal Himalaya. The Lesser Himalaya is known as Mahabharat Range in this region. Okay, the range is crossed by several rivers like Ghagra, Gandak and Kosi. In between the Great and the Lesser Himalayas, there are Kathmandu and Pokhara, okay, valleys. And the Shivalik Range come very close to the Lesser Himalaya towards the east and is almost non-existent beyond the Gandak River. Next is Assam Himalaya. The part of Himalaya which lies between Tista and Dihang River is known as Assam Himalaya. Okay. And between Tista River and the Dihang River. And it stretches for a distance of about 720 km. The Eastern Himalaya or Assam Himalaya mainly occupies the areas of Arunachal Pradesh and our neighboring country, Bhutan. The Assam Himalaya show a marked dominance of fluvial erosion due to very very heavy rainfall. Okay, and after this, the Himalayas take a sudden southward turn after the Dihang Gorge, and the hill ranges running in more or less north-south direction. Okay, along India's border with Myanmar, that is known as Rumanchal. Now there are various regional names of Himalaya. So some of the important regional names of Himalaya include the Ganesh Himal, the Sagarmatha Himal, the Annapurna Himal, and the Dholagiri Himal.
So you can see here, this is the part of Himalaya lying in Punjab, Himachal and Kashmir. This is known as Punjab Himalaya. Okay, and it is between Indus and Satluj River, this part of Himalaya. The next is this part, that is the Kumaon Himalaya between Satluj and the Kali River. Alright, and then next is the Nepal Himalaya between Kali and Tista River. Okay, and last is the Assam Himalaya, okay, between Tista of Sikkim River and Dihang River, okay, here, and some part also lies in Arunachal Pradesh. Alright, so this is river Brahmaputra, which enters here. Okay, Brahmaputra, and Brahmaputra marks the easternmost boundary of the Himalaya. Okay, so after making a gorg here, Dihang gorg, it enters into the state of Arunachal Pradesh. And there you can see Himalayas here, beyond this Dihang gorg, bend sharply to the south and forms a boundary, natural barrier or boundary between Myanmar and India. This is known as Eastern Himalayas or Purvanchal. So, Purvanchal, the features of Purvanchal: Himalayas bend sharply to the south beyond the Dihang gorg and move towards to form a covering the eastern boundary of the country. They are known as the Eastern or Purvanchal Hills. It extended in the northeastern states of India. Most of these hills are extended along the border of India and Myanmar, while others are inside India, namely Patkai Hills, Naga Hills and Mijo Hills. The next feature is, these Purvanchal are mostly composed of strong sandstones, that is sedimentary rock. Okay, so sedimentary rocks are found mostly there, and these Himalayas, part of Himalaya, that is Purvanchal, is also covered with dense forest. Okay, and also there are deep valleys located, okay, and curved out by the rivers. The Purvanchal mainly comprises of these following hills, like the Patkai Hills, Naga Hills, Manipur Hills and the Mijo Hills. Patkai Bum Hills, situated India's northeastern border with Myanmar. The word Patkai means to cut chicken. Okay. It is originated by the same tectonic processes that resulted in the formation of Himalayas in the Mesozoic. These hills are known for conical peaks, steep slopes, deep valleys, but they are not as rough as the Himalaya. The whole region is surrounded by the forest comprising of sandstones. Then comes the Naga Hills. It is located in India, extending into Myanmar, which forms a divide between India and Myanmar. Then it is the Manipur Hills. It is located in the north of Nagaland, Mizoram in the south, Upper Myanmar in the east, and Assam in the west, bound Manipur Hills. Mijo Hills. It is formerly called Lusai Hills. It is located too in southeastern Mizoram state, northeastern India, forming part of the North Arakanyoma system. Now there are some other hills also in eastern states of India. The Garo you can see, the Khasi Hills and Jayantia Hills. Garo, Khasi and Jayantia Hills. Garo Hills is located in Meghalaya state and part of Garo Khasi range, which is considered as one of the wettest place on the earth. Khasi Hills, it is part of Garo Khasi range in Meghalaya and got its name Khasi tribe, which are found in this region. Cherrapunji is situated in the eastern Khasi hills. Okay. And then comes the Jayantia hills, is located further to the east from the Khasi hills. And this is the location of Patkaibum hills, the Naga hills. And below it we have the Mijo hills. Now, let us see the differences between the Western Himalayas and the Eastern Himalayas. Number first, Western Himalayas extends from Jammu and Kashmir to Himachal Pradesh. Eastern Himalayas are located in states of West Bengal, Sikkim and Arunachal Pradesh mainly. Western Himalayas are called Punjab Himalayas and Kumaon Himalayas, whereas Eastern Himalayas are called Assam Himalayas and Purvanchal Himalayas. There are important ranges in Western Himalayas like Jaskar Range, Karakoram Range, Pir Panjal Range, whereas Eastern Himalayas are known for smaller hills like Naga Hills, Patkai Hills, okay, and also extends up to Garo, Khasi Jayantia Hills and Mijo Hills. Next is number 4. The important passes of Western Himalaya includes the Karakoram Pass, Jojila Pass, Shipkila Pass. Whereas Eastern Himalayas are also known for some important passes like Nathula and Bomdila Pass. Now Western Himalayas are higher than Eastern Himalayas. Western Himalayas are higher than the Eastern Himalayas. And Western Himalayas, they do not receive more rainfall, but Eastern Himalayas receives more rainfall. Parts of Meghalaya and Assam, Manipur, Mizoram, they receive more amount of rainfall. Okay. Now, number 7 is Western Himalayas are very, very broad. If you remember, the width of Himalayas in Jammu and Kashmir, it was about 400 kilometer, okay. And in Arunachal Pradesh, that is in Eastern Himalaya, it is about 150 kilometer. Alright. The Eastern Himalaya is more prone to earthquakes and landslides. Temperature is much less in the Western Himalayas than the Eastern Himalaya. So, these are some of the important differences between Western Himalaya and the Eastern Himalayas. And this is the end of students' today's class. Thank you.